Oh my God. Happy to see you all back. I think you all would have seen me having a mic. And actually, I like singing. So I've been following from so much of singers and into different part of the world. And I like more and more there with that. So you would have seen my mic. So today we're going to bring some special guests. And in a pandemic heroes in our insurance industry, but she's not only the insurance advisor, and she's too more passionate into singing, dancing, and all this being like an all-rounder kind of things being profiled. I met her on to Miami Global Conference, and she was being with me one of the, so we become a very close friend. After that, we been started following her. Her passion about on the singing, and she developed herself. This is wonderful one. I, you know, you all can agree with that. Not everybody can become a good singer, right? So she followed up. And same timely, she has been doing extremely into business also. Last year in the pandemic, she qualified quote of the table. So today I'm going to invite her to our interview, how she balanced both of them, what make motivate her to being with a top producer as well as being a singing also. So I have a lot of mindset in different countries I'm connecting, but I always feel my close friends who are there into one of my countries that they help me slowly. I become so much of friendly with them. And a lot of friends right now in that particular country. So I've been, they mean treated as my second home. I am Nanda then is in Mexico, and I've started learning a lot of words into Spanish and hola, Grescas, and they are teaching me a lot of words. And even maybe after I visit Mexico, I'll be more into being talking into Spanish. And I want to do one program full and full with Spanish, and I'm taking that to be it. Before inviting our guest to a program, just taking our inviting our profile to, then we move ahead. I have a lot of question answer and I'm a lot of fun. And never forget, I'll ask her to sing one song for our special members for that. Okay, sure. I'm just taking a profile. So we got today a special guest, Fernanda Calva. So she asked from Mexico, and today we're going to talk about let the passion drive your professional. So I'm just taking a Fernanda's profile. Fernanda is happy to be an insurance professional, being her clients achieve their financial goals and convinced about graduates. She, it is about her, how she's been targetly been moved to the financial professional. Before coming to insurance industry, she was been to be a different industries like marketing, advertising, public relationships, journalism, radio, productions. So after that, I don't know, what made her to come to the choose this particular profession? Then later we have to ask her. From 2016 onwards, she started doing it and be a successful insurance advisor. She qualified to be an recognized such a regional champion, a new agent, and be an international convention winner for multiple campaigns. And she is an MDRT mentor. And she also be an MDRT qualifier. She traveled all the way from different meetings, and she qualified 5 times MDRT in that. Last year in the pandemic, she qualified quote of the table. And I'm very proud to say that she one of my friends. So, and we'll be knowing her friend and what was the success she be able to done on the quote of the table in the pandemic time. And apart from that, she also currently studying financial service certified professional, FSCM diploma into American college and most prestigious college in the United States financially matters. And to be Mexican institution of insurance bonds, BC, IMESAFSC, always seeking to be best prepared to the advice to the client. She also teacher of mental application science that study out. So you can see that she profile getting a lot of things being more on that. Governing mind is eliminated about brief, maintained through the good among the topics that she the student. So this is about her profile. I'm not taking much time here about profiling. I'm just going to invite our guest, and we're going to see a lot of singing today, and she's going to be a lot of answerings out to place on that. So I'm just inviting Fernanda all the way from Mexico. Hi, Fernanda.
Hi, friend. How are you? I'm very honored. I'm very happy to be here. I'm very proud. I'm a big fan of your show, your interviews. So it's great to be here with you. Thank you very much for the invitation.
It's a wonderful day because I love singing. So my a lot of people because it's come from the heart, right? So a lot of singing and everything. And this pandemic times, we could not able to move out of our home, and we have to be the most stressful times and other thing. Whenever I see your Facebook pages, it will fill up with a lot of colorfulness with the singing. Could be Spanish, but the voice what we change it, and you also your English was very good. And I loved it, and been connected with me in so many years. I think it's almost 2019, right? Almost 3 years we've been connecting and discussing a lot of things. Hope and this pandemic ends and we will meet you in Boston. I'm waiting to do that. So tell me, Fernanda, so how motivated to do what bring you this professional both, like singing and insurance advisors? How would this took place?
Well, I am very happy to be an insurance agent. You were reading my profile. I used to work in marketing and advertisement, social media. So I was doing like social media and communication for different insurance companies here in Mexico. So I already knew some of the products and the like the policies I used to have my own insurance, health insurance and investment and everything. I had a lot of friends in the industry and they were telling me like, come to work with us. And I was like, how am I going to be like in this industry since I studied communication and I was like in a different world. But I tried and then I started in the business and I loved, well, at first it was like great to me, like I didn't have more schedules, like work schedules, and I didn't have a boss, like a formal boss. We don't have a salary, but I had the time to sing because it's like my greatest passion in life. My daughter was a musician. She passed away last year. So when I discovered that in this business, you have like the discipline and you can organize your days and do like your hobbies, I fall in love in this business, but not because of the money. That is a great business, you know, the commissions and everything and the prizes that we win. But I think that we help people to have like a present that they can be sure that their families are protected and that they will have like a great future. And they obviously, I always tell my assistant that we work with the most valuable things in people, that is the money, the family, the health. So I love my job. I'm very passionate about it. But I also love that I can have the time to do the singing and I write my own songs and to be in the studio. And you know that my clients know this as well, and they know me like in both sides, my A side that I'm an insurance agent and as a singer, but I can like do both things, and I'm like very fortunate that I've been like successful in both.
No, one thing I have to be proudly say that whenever I see you, I think I just proud myself being an insurance advisor, right? Nothing stop us being your professional as well as your passion. You're going to be a good singer. And I know I recently into her, Lara, she even about biking. Same time, she'll be an insurance advisor. She's from Lebanon. So I think all these mainly on female, right? So it's called the superpower to manage both, like how we in managing a family as well as a professional. I'm very proud of you. And how's the situation in Mexico right now? So were you able to meet a lot of clients, business? How this COVID took place? How was this situation right now?
Honestly, I think the insurance industry in Mexico has been like the one that has been like doing good in the pandemic, because the people now, they're like more conscious of to be like, they are aware that we have to be protected, like in health or life insurance. Unfortunately, I have my dad passed away, and a friend of mine who was very young. So now we know that it doesn't matter how old you are, you can like pass away. So they have been like looking for these services a little bit more. At the beginning, I think they were a little bit scared because of the crisis and everything, but they know that they have to be protected. So in health insurance and life insurance, I think we were growing a lot. Investment was a little bit slower because they didn't want to risk. But right now, I think that this has been helpful for a lot of us, as well as insurance agents, but as the people, to know that they have to be protected because it can happen, a pandemic or whatever that changes their lives.
Wonderful. Wonderful. And I'm so sorry about your father losses. And I know how difficult it was, a COVID, because I'm the person who has been affected. I know that. But we have to overcome that. I think you rightly put it on that. So the awareness across the world, it has increased, and it does not end till now. Still it's growing, right? So we need to be more precautions before time definitely took place. So Fernanda, I'm taking to your interview now. We are moving into the Q&A. And so, like everybody, just asking your questions on that. So you've been into the singing, right? So do singing as well as the professionals. You travel to the different professional, have been moved to this. So how many years you started doing for singing from the beginning? You started from the beginning, right? So the professional took place, how long this passionate to be singing, and why you have decided to come on insurance life advisor?
Okay, the singing, I was singing, I think, since I was two, because I don't know, like very little, because my dad used to be a musician. He was a bass player, the best one. And so I was like always singing with him. I was always learning, trying to play the guitar or whatever, but I love singing more. So yeah, like when I was like 12, I was recording with my dad, like my first songs, and I used to write my song as well. So when I went to college, I wanted to study music, but my mom was like, no, you have to study something else, because it's like very difficult, you know, the beliefs that are in the music industry and entertainment. So I studied communications, that in a kind of way, it's like useful for it. And I love my career. You can do a lot of things in communications, like, you know, about everything and anything at the same time. And then I did a master in institution communication, that it's like for the companies. But I focused more in like in marketing, advertisement, and I used to be like as well in radio and TV production and everything. But as I told you, I was doing advertisement for different insurance companies, because I have friends that are there like since, I don't know, 15 years or something. So they were telling me like, you should come with to work with us, because I love people. I love making friends. I love being connected with a lot of people. So they told me that you have like the profile, but I was like, I can sell anything. I didn't know about like sales, about, I don't know. I was like very afraid. I used to think that you have to born with this sales profile, and I used to think that I didn't have it. But when I stepped and I was like, okay, I'm gonna try it, because they were telling me and telling me, so they convinced me. So I was okay, I'm gonna try the jobs that I have. They have like schedules that I used to got it at 9 a.m. and then till, I don't know, 11 p.m. or 12 p.m. or I don't know. So it was a lot of hours. And then I started, obviously, you know, the certifications and exams and everything. And I started contacting all my friends from all the jobs that I had. So it was like very quick for me. The beginning, I started like to make a lot of businesses, obviously with help of my promoter and everything. So I was like, wow, this is a very good business. I think that the part of the sales techniques and the things that you have to say and the objections, you can learn it, like everything in life, you know? You can, I read a lot. I listen to podcasts. I listen to like your interviews on YouTube. I search for a lot of things. I get into classes, courses, and everything. So I think you can learn that if you focus in learning. But the things that I think that are the most important is like the emotional part, because as you know, the insurance agent career is sometimes like very lonely. Like you get frustrated, and if you don't have that, like this perseverance and that it doesn't matter, and like to learn how to manage rejection and everything, like that's why a lot of people like run away from the profession very quickly. So I have been learning as well and growing in a personal way, so I can manage my emotions, because I think it's like a very important thing for our career. So I have been like learning and learning. I have 5 years now, but I think I have like very few experience. I sometimes see a lot of people that are members, MDRT members for 20 years, 30 years. I'm like, wow, no, they're like awesome. I want to be like them. And I think I have to work on me to be on capacitation and to, I don't know, like it's a business well, where you have to keep up with everything. Yeah. So we have to be prepared to assess our clients the best way possible. But it's a very good business. Well, you have to be disciplined. You have to have perseverance. But you as well have the time to do the passion. So when I was working in other businesses, I didn't have the time to be singing as much as I'm doing right now. So that's another thing that I was like, wow, I can sing more. And they invite me to projects now. And I'm like, yeah, I can do on Monday. I'm not going to put any things of insurance. I'm going to dedicate that day to be singing in whatever with an artist or something. But if I have to be working on a Sunday with a client in insurance, I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna do it as well. So I think it's a great business, and you can do whatever you want, your hobby, and mix it up very well.
Wonderful. I know the way you talk about it, you love the professional. So this gives a lot of time for you to balance both of them, right? That's a wonderful way to look it up. So what kind of habits you follow? So regularly you keep yourself to be successful. What kind of habits you just keep yourself on a regular basis? So you did not disturb the both professional as well as passion.
But what kind of what?
What kind of habits you follow with that?
Advice?
No, not advice, habit.
Habit, okay, I'm sorry. So I have like a routine, everyday routine, where in the morning, I read. Well, my dad was to be very religious man. Well, he said it wasn't like religious, but he used to be a Christian. So they he tried to share that with me. So every day I read something of the Bible. I'm not very religious, but I'm trying because I think the spiritual part is very important for every person. So I read the Bible. Then I have like, I have a little notebook, like it's a gratitude notebook. Well, in one side, I put, I write down all the things that I feel thankful for. And in the other side, I put all the things that I want to be thankful for, like in the future. So for example, I write down, I'm thankful for being top of the table, like MDRT top of the table for next year, for example. And I try to visualize that as something that it's already here. So every day to start with these positive things, like things that you feel thankful for, or you want to be thankful for, it gives you like a different spirit to start the day. I also do in this thing that I studied, that is mental application. There are like lines of thoughts that it's like the same thing in a way of the gratitude that it's funny and it sounds fantastic sometimes, but I write every day that I'm the winner of the best like award in my company here in Mexico, and everything that I want to happen in my life. So because you have like two choices, you can be in the negative side. And I can tell you, it's very difficult for an agent here in Mexico because of the crisis, or it's a very difficult industry, or the people are like afraid, or we don't have the culture. And it's like true in a certain way, but I can be as well in the other side, like in the positive side. Well, when I can say, I am a very good insurance agent. The people trust in me. The people need our products here. The people are more aware of the insurance, health insurance or life insurance products. And both sides are true, but you have to choose where to put your focus on, like in the negative side or in the positive side. So each morning I try to be like in a positive mind, because it is like the way how you're going to go all the day. If you start your day like, I'm very, I don't know, frustrated, I'm stressed, and I wake up late and everything, like your appointments with the clients are going to be different. I think we live in a world of energy, so you can like pass your energy to the other people. So whenever I'm everything now it's via Zoom. So when I'm with the client, I think they can feel my energy. So if I'm okay and I'm grateful and I'm positive, I think we have a better chance to make a sale. So this routine that I have every day, like to start my day, it helps me like with the emotional part. And then I have a lot of conversations in WhatsApp. I almost all my communication with my clients are like in social media, WhatsApp, and I try every day to communicate with them, not just like when it's like the renovation or whatever, the renewal, but I don't know, like to become friends with them so they can trust me, I can trust them. I'm very active in social media because I want to share that with my friends and clients and to do like a close relationship with them. And I try to do my appointments. I make friends every day. So we cannot, we have to make friends. That's part of our business. So I'm very active in different like circles. I take classes. I have a reading book club. I have I dance as well. So I'm with a lot of people, obviously talking about my business as well. So I'm also in a networking club. Every Monday we connect via Zoom, and it's a place where there are different professions. For example, there is a doctor, and then some guy that sells mezcal, and then another guy who has a barbershop. And so we have to give them referrals for their business, and they have to give me referrals for the insurance. So I am very active in this group so we can like connect with more people. I think our job is like very fun because I sometimes feel that we're not working. Like I'm just like talking with friends, but we are. And the things that we sell are like for the health and the family and the money of the people. So it's like an everyday thing. And I'm talked to my friends and I'm like, you have to get it. It doesn't matter if you get it with me, but as an advice, as a friend, I tell you that you have to be saving for your retirement, or you have to get something for the education of your kids. And you're like in a way working, but you're like just talking with the people. So that's what I do every day. Obviously I have my interviews with the clients. Now we can have like in different hours because I don't drive anymore. So that way, like you can take advantage of the situation. And as well, I read a lot about insurance or about the all the things like personal growth. I think that's it. I try to, if for example, you send me like the interview, I'm like, if you don't have time, well, you're driving to the supermarket, or well, you're like, I don't know, taking a shower, for example, I'm like listening to insurance advice. Like you can like be working at the same time as other things. And as well, like sometimes I'm singing when I'm doing a different thing. I don't know, like you can mix your activities a lot and take advantage of your day.
Perfect. And sometimes I feel that reduce the stress also. You don't get business, right? Like, at least you do some singing. I started listening to singing when I've been alone. Sometimes clients know the appointment skipped. So let's just
so that's sometimes my friends tell me sometimes like, at what time do you work? Like you're always like singing or doing this and that and everything. I'm like, I don't do like right now like a selfie because I'm working with a client. But that thing, like you can I don't know, identify more or talk about different things with your clients. Like my clients, they know that I sing, but they know as well that I am very committed with my work. Like every time they write me or whatever, I respond immediately to them because I want to make them know that I'm a very committed person with my work. It's not that I am a singer and I sometimes do the insurance. No, I'm an insurance agent that happens to be like in the singing industry as well. But Nowadays, I think you can do that. Like, it's different now. You can do like two passions, three or whatever at the same time with the same discipline, passion, and I don't know.
It's a God gift for you because you make yourself happy, you make others happy to listening to your song, right? So that's a two way to look into that. So thank you so much. I just admire about your answers, right? So what kind of learnings you are doing it regularly? You do any specific learning apart from that you are doing it with studies and that about insurance? Any specific learning you are doing in insurance?
As you told in my presentation, I just finished this, I don't know how it's called in English, but it's like a master. It was 2 years that I was in this class that it was about finance and insurance. And it was great because it was like a study group. Well, we have a lot of literature, but I think that it's very important. It was with the American College, and it was about different topics, retirement, taxes, finance planning. And I just finished that on December. And now I am starting a new study group with different friends in different companies here in Mexico. So we can share about different cases. I think in the industry, you never stop learning because, for example, in health insurance, for example, the diseases or the accidents or the cases, and you have to keep up with it. It's like sometimes difficult because it's like, oh, I don't know about that. But you have to have like your group of friends that you can ask. And you have to be like very honest with your clients. Sometimes like, I don't know, I haven't had a case like that, but I'm going to help you. They know that we are always like in the side of the client, like we work for the industry, for our companies, but the thing is that we are learning every day and taking the courses and reading and everything so we can help our clients to take advantage of their insurance. So I just finished that course, but now I'm in the study group. Obviously, like in the meetings, like regular meetings with my agency, with my company. And I have like all my books that I bought in MDRT, like here. Mm-hmm. And sometimes I take it like before a meeting with a client. So I can have like some phrases that you can get or like to refresh yourself. And yeah, it's great. I have it like here besides my desk. So whatever I have time, I try to keep learning because it's not the same. The book that I read it like 5 years ago, but I was a very different agent. So I read it again so I can learn like a different thing. So I have a new perspective in that.
Wonderful. Can you refer some kind of courses to your new advisors in Mexico? So they want to become MDRT or something. What was your suggestion to them? Any courses or any learning they must do?
That they must read? Okay, so I wasn't prepared, but for example, here, I have all this. These are actually MDRT objections manual. So it's awesome because you have it here and you have like the different objections of the client and everything, every day is different, but you can, you can like read this responses of the objections and it's great. So these manuals of the MDRT are awesome. These are, another book.
Yeah, idea.
Well, they're in Spanish, but, and then I have a lot of, these books, I bought them in MDRT. So it's great because you have like all the books that help you in sales techniques and like the objection manuals and everything. And as well, as I told you, all the personal growth like emotional intelligence and everything, I think it's like fundamental. And you can, in YouTube, look for insurance tips and insurance speakers and everything, podcasts and Spotify. Like there's a lot of material. Exactly. Like you sent like that's the interview. Obviously you want to know what they're doing. So that, but you have to put it in practice. So that's obviously the difference. And I always tell like my friends that are new in this business that you have to be patient. Like that's the most important thing. Like you have to be patient to understand that this is a marathon, it's not a race. And you have to be like waiting, like you have to be, how do you say, how do you say it in English? Well, you have to construct the relationships and wait. For example, I have 5 years now and I am selling to people that I saw the first time 5 years ago. And I do like, I keep with my, how do you say, like?
Checklist, manual.
No, like my, how do you say it? Like my notebook.
Okay.
Notebook, like agenda,
to-do list,
let's say it like that. But for example, if a client tells me like I can't do it right now, but maybe on June, okay, so in June I write down, look for that guy because he was going to vacation and then his mom, whatever, blah, blah, blah. So in June, I call him and I'm like, hi, how are you? How was your vacation? And how's your mom? And he's like, oh, she remembered because I write everything down. And I have like in front of my desk, a lot of post-its with these reminders, like I have to call this guy and I have to give this for a guy. I every day look for the birthday so I can keep up with like the events. Or for example, if there is a baby that is born, I send something to my client. So the thing is that you have to be like continuous in touch with your clients and with your prospects as well. So that's why like they always keep you in mind and they think of you like an expert in the subject.
So wonderful that you've been showed an ideas what we are doing right now. The main point I'm coming right now is that you qualified quote of the table in the pandemic. What was the secret? What kind of prospecting idea, fact finding you utilized it on the pen?
It was like a surprise for me because at the same time I was dealing with my dad's cancer. But I think it was because I took advantage of the situation in the way that I started to see our business in a different way. It's a thing that it's a very different situation when you have insurance and, for example, you are dealing with a disease. If you have health insurance, you are not focusing in the money as well as the recovery of your family. So I think that the personal situation helped me to communicate that with my clients to demonstrate that it's something good for their family. So I was like, I don't want you to live the same thing as me with my dad. I want you to feel protected. I want you to be in peace. For example, obviously I had the check of my life insurance, like for my dad. So I feel that obviously the loss of a father, it's very difficult, but to have a life insurance, it helps you in a way. So I've been telling that to my clients and to my friends, and I think they are more aware, like, about health, about life insurance, about saving money, because all the people that didn't have a job at the beginning of the pandemic, or they were having like the half of their salary, and they're like, wow, like when I'm old, I'm not going to be like receiving the same amount of the salary, or if I don't save money now, it's going to be worse. So I think like I use these personal situations and what I have learned with my dad or my clients, and I communicate that to my clients, and I think like they're like more open to listen to it. It's difficult as well, but I think when you are selling, like thinking first in your client and you forget about your commissions, then it surprises you. Like it happened to me. I was like, before, well, I'm a very competitive person. I love to win. I love to go to the trips or whatever, and obviously qualifying MDRT. And I was like, always, like, yeah, I have to tell, and I would let policies and everything. And then with the pandemic, I was like, wow, I have to concentrate in my family and my dad and everything. But at the same time, I was working and communicating the same thing to my clients. And then I was scared of the table. I think it is because it's a genuine advice, and you're telling them, like, you have to get it, like, it doesn't matter if I'm your agent or no, or you go to a different company, but there are products that can change your life, like very drastically. So I think when they see a genuine interest in helping them, like you're not just selling some stuff like for now, that is a thing that they can that can help them in a different way in health and insurance and money and family, like they change their minds and they're like more open. I think, I don't know, it's focusing always in the client's needs, in the client's benefit, and then you benefit yourself from it.
So in this journey, you'd have seen a lot of rejections and failure, right? So how you face it, like this same smile, or how you been took it positively? Because I slowly getting into Facebook, you know, a lot of friends after the seeing those videos and asking that they simply could not able to face the failures right now. So what was your view on that?
Well, but rejection at the beginning is like harder because you're not used to it. So I remember that I don't know, I sent a message, a text message via WhatsApp or whatever, and they didn't answer. And I was like, oh, no, like I felt like very bad. I was like about to cry or I don't know. But the things that I learned, if they don't answer, it's a problem, right? It's not mine. And it's about like the amount of prospects that you have. If I write to one person and they don't answer, I call one person and they don't answer, they don't give me an appointment or something like that, Well, you have to call maybe 10 other people, right? So that's what I do. Like, I have a lot of friends. I try to get a meeting with them. So I call 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if the first person doesn't answer, rejects me or whatever, I forgot about it, but because I have 9 other people that I'm talking with, or if they don't answer as well, well, you have to try with 20 more. Like, it doesn't matter. And if I like cross with them, like in the street, I'm not like, I hate you because you didn't give me a meter or something. No, it's like, I know that sometimes they don't know how to like tell you no, like in Mexico we're like that, or like, yeah, I'm going to get this policy, and then they disappear. It doesn't matter. Like, the people are in different situations as well. Maybe they're like in a bad situation, facing a problem, we don't know. So the thing is that you have to keep doing it and not taking like personally. It's not personal. If they are like dealing with their own lives, their own issues, so you have like just to keep up, and it's about that, like the quantity, like the, if you have a biggest amount of calls or a biggest amount of prospects, it doesn't matter if the first one told you no. And it's funny because sometimes some person that I wanted to meet with, then 2 years later, they call me like, hi, you're still in the insurance industry. I want to buy you something. And I'm like, you didn't answer before, but now you do. So it doesn't matter. You have to be like, I don't know, like, yeah, not taking personal things and always looking for more people.
That's wonderful. That's a key of success. I always believe that prospecting one. Now, in this pandemic, and specifically in Mexico, what kind of successful prospecting ideas worked for you?
Well, I think this thing about the networking that I was telling you about is a great opportunity. I think like they're in all the countries all over the world. Well, the thing is that you have to give referrals to other businesses, but like you have to have a genuine interest to helping them. So I think that's a great way. Also in Facebook, for example, all the groups in Facebook, I am very active in the groups. For example, there is a group here in Mexico that are like the moms that live like around my house or everything. I don't have kids, but I'm in that group. So, and they're selling like different stuff. Like they sell candles and they sell food and they sell gifts or whatever. So when I have to get something, for example, for my grandmother, I have to get her a gift. Instead of going to a regular store to get a gift from her, for her, I go to this Facebook group and I buy something for that lady that sells candles, for example. So I am buying something from her at first. And then I'm like, hey, I'm an insurance agent. Can we meet so I can present you my services and everything? And obviously she's going to tell you yes, but because you already bought something from her. So that's the way like I work. I try to give first and then you have the person, and it doesn't matter. Sometimes it's not this in the same channel. Maybe that person doesn't get anything from it. Yeah, but The universe works like that. So when you're giving people, you're going to receive. So that's another way that I look prospects. And for example, this book club that I told you, it was a prospect, it's not a client. And she was like, do you like reading? And yeah, I love reading. It's one of my hobbies and everything. And she was like, we have a book club that we do via Zoom every Wednesday. And at first I was like, oh no, I'm going to be like with a bunch of nerds like reading. Oh no. But then I was like, no, yeah. And first I like reading. And two, obviously I have like now 20 new friends that now they're like, four of them, they're my clients. And there I have a lot of prospects. And I'm doing one of my hobbies that is reading. I love the book club, but I am meeting new people. And then I go to the salsa dance lessons because I love to dance. And there's a lot of people. Or I go to the nail salon where I do my nails. And every month I go and pay for my nails. Well, obviously there's an owner of that business. So I tell her, you know, I'm an insurance agent. Can you give me an interview so I can present, blah, blah, blah. And obviously she tells me yes, because every month I'm in their business doing my nails. So you just have to go to the street and you have like to be aware of all the people that you have around. You have a lot of prospects.
No, in my 50 interviews, this is something, the broad explanation how to do prospecting, and you've been so experienced on that. All the best for your TOT. I think you will crack top of the table soon. This will give a lot of insight, not only in Mexico. Now the people talk about, I don't have the prospect, I don't have the business. You need to, the word you used it, go to the street, find the way. That is the only way to do it. I see that sometimes you take your dogs to the pet clinic. There is a prospect, right?
Exactly. I go every day to the doctor with my dogs. And yeah, whatever place you go every day, there is a prospect. So yeah, you just have to be aware of that.
So can you share about your families and currently what are the products you focusing for your client?
Okay, so... it's like a mix about in the beginning it was a lot of investment, like this life insurance with savings, and now I'm focusing more as well health insurance. It's like you have to know the person at first. So the way that I work, it's like in two meetings. In the first one, I want to learn everything about the client. So I ask him like, you have a children, how's the situation of your parents? Do you save now? Do you have debts? Do you have loans? How's your education? What do you think about the education for your kids? Do you have pets? What's your hobbies? Like a lot of things, because I want to know how they think and what they need. Because sometimes they can tell me, well, I want to invest all my money, but in high risk and everything. I'm like, well, yes, but you don't have health insurance first. In our country, it's very difficult, like the public system. So first, I want to know that you are protected, and then you step up to the invest thing. So it's like listening to your client at first. You can recommend something like with your experience, and also listen to what their goals are. Like, what do you want to achieve in life? Do you want to get married? Do you want to have family? Do you want to get a house? Or how do you imagine in your retirement? And you can be like, oh, do you think that you want to, I don't know, say for your the university of your children? And then you make like a commitment with your client for the second meeting, and they tell you like, yeah, I want to know more about health insurance, but I want a life insurance policy because I'm the I don't know, the father of three little kids, so they have to be protected if I'm not there. Like, you help them discover their needs. Sometimes they don't know what they need, because they're like sometimes issues that they don't talk about every day. So you help them like to think and to discover what they need first. And then I write everything down and I tell them like, I'm going to prepare you something like to help you achieve these goals, to be protected, to be saving for your retirement, for the college of your kids or whatever. And in the second meeting, I present, like I do a very good like PowerPoint and everything, personalized and everything. And I'm like, I want to explain like the benefits and all the conditions and whatever. And I want them to buy the thing. Like, I don't want to sell. I want them to buy the proposal that I gave them, because they're like, the proposal is like for them, it's like especially. I don't focus in a product. Like, I sell this policy or this kind of insurance. I look at the situation of the prospect, and I have and I want to help them like with the situation, like the actual situation and the goals that they want to achieve. So it's like a combination of things, but always like focusing in the client's needs first.
Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. And I agree with that. So the Insta products, the solution is mandatory, but each one have different solutions, right? I agree with you. Did MDRT help in your professional? Why insurance advisors need MDRT?
I love MDRT. First, you can have friends all over the world, for example, like us. But it's a great opportunity. Like, it's a goal for me every year, because I want to be part of the like of the best organization of the insurance industry, obviously. And it gives you like all the things that you need to be a great insurance agent. The events, I love the events. Obviously, when you meet like person to person, it's better. But as I show you all the books that I have here, you get books that you cannot get in another place. You meet with other people. And sometimes it's just a phrase or just a thought or just like a different perspective that has like, oh, wow, yeah, I didn't like used to think about it that way. And like the speakers that they have, like they're like very experienced speakers, like in the main platform that are obviously like very famous and experienced and everything. And then you meet with people of your countries as well, of different companies, that you become like the study group that I told you about. Obviously it was from MDRT members of different companies here in Mexico that like, I couldn't know like other way. It was from MDRT. So I think it's a great way to know that you're not alone as a agent, because as I told you, like the life insurance agent career sometimes is very lonely. So you have to like search for friends and look for things that can help you. And sometimes like you are like with the same friends in your agency, like very like in your bubble. But when you go to MDRT and see everything like that in the whole countries, and you're like, wow. And to meet all the people and the cultures and everything, it's a great experience. I always tell my friends, the new ones in the industry, that you have to achieve this goal. You have to be in the event, like for to with all the speakers, like with in all your the conference and everything, and all the parties as well, and go to the bookstore and get the books, and you form like part of a great community where all the best agents are. So obviously I want to be always there.
Wonderful. And that's what we connected with MDRT, right? So thank you for MDRT. And
and we will meet in Boston.
Yeah. Happy to meet, because it was long waiting, right? We could not have been lost 2 years and not been in person, I think.
Yes.
With the COVID, live with COVID. So we just have to meet up and looking forward, like take it forward from there actually to place. Yeah, you have very good knowledge in English as well as in Spanish both, right? So what was your secret and how you learned it, or how it is, was that?
Well, I lived in Miami for 3 years. My mom lives in Miami, in the US, like since, I don't know, 24, 25 years ago. She got married with American Colombian. So she went there. My brothers and sisters they live in Miami. Well, my brother Sebastian now is in Boston. He is studying at MIT. Like, he's super intelligent and smart. So I was living in Miami for 3 years in high school, but Miami is not the best place to learn English, because they're like, oh yeah, you went to Miami, everybody speaks Spanish. So I was speaking English just in class, just in high school, but outside of that, I was just speaking Spanish. So, and then I have to improve my English because I don't practice here anymore. So I'm practicing with you. I'm not used to speak English anymore. But yeah, watching Netflix. Watching Netflix, singing songs in English as well.
Same thing. I too start learning a lot of languages, like in this, I talk about Spanish. I love Spanish to learn a lot of things about. So, how this Mexican market right now in the insurance industry over there? So what was your view on that?
Well, it's very surprising because it has been growing a lot. There is a lot of new agents that they started in the pandemic, that they have never met their clients in the real life. So they've been selling all via Zoom. And it's because of what I was telling you, the people are now more open to listen to the insurance products. I think it's easier like to get appointments because, well, for me, it's easier like, okay, let's Zoom. So you don't have to move like outside of your house and everything. So I think it's easier to get more meetings with clients. They're more open because they're aware of the importance. Obviously there are like some people that are like still afraid of the situation, or here in Mexico because of the politics or everything. But I think the pandemic has being helpful for us. Like, as every crisis, if you don't get something good of the crisis, you have not learned anything. So we have to learn about this. And the things that we have to learn about COVID is that we can die whenever, like you don't have to be old. My dad was 56. He was very young. My friend was 39. And well, a lot of people and clients had passed away as well. So we have to learn that we are mortals, that we have to live our best, and we have to protect our family. And so I think like the Mexican culture now is like, yeah, I have kids, now I have to get an insurance. Or yeah, if I don't have a salary, it's a very difficult problem, so I have to start saving for my retirement. I think it has helped, like in a way. It is going to be always difficult if you want to see it like that, but we have to take advantage of the opportunity that the crisis has helped, like to make conscious in the whole world, not just in Mexico.
So any specific message or thanks to your clients all these years you've traveled?
To my clients, that I love my clients, that I feel very blessed to have these clients, because I don't see them as clients. I see them as friends. As I told you, when they signed like the contract, I signed with them, and then I tell them like, now we have a relationship. It's like a marriage, because they're like a long, how do you say, like for example, the savings policies, that is a long year.
Long-term policies.
Long-term. So it's long-term. So I always tell them like, we're going to see each other for a long time. We better be friends. So I have them in my social media and everything, because I want them to have like a close relationships. I want to know about their lives, if they change jobs, if they have a new kid, if they move somewhere else and everything. So now I can tell you that they're my friends. I'm very thankful. I'm very thankful that they trust me in the beginning of my career, where I didn't have a lot of experience. And I want to tell them that I love my job, and that I'm going to be here like every day whenever they need me. And that obviously that I want to be with them when they get the checks for the university or the retirements, or to help them when they have sometimes an accident or disease or whatever, to help them like to that difficult times, like to get better. So I'm very happy. They're not my clients, they are my friends.
wonderful. That, very proud of you. And I think they are also proud of you. And just putting it to the final two questions are there. So can you recommend one advice or habits, the new advisors around the world? So what was your experience advices they are to follow?
For the new ones, they have to be, like I told you, patient. I should tell them like, stay in this career, you're in the right career. It's like, it's a very good business. You're helping people. You sell good products to your clients. But you have to be growing personal and in an emotional way. So you have to keep up with like the perseverance, with the discipline, and with the rejection and everything. So you have to be patient, not to like, I am not selling anything in 2 months and I'm going to go in a different business. No, like stay, but you have to study, like to be prepared, because obviously if you're prepared, you have more chances to sell, and you're preparing to assess, like to help the people, like to get more of their products. I think it's like the best way possible, where you can grow your own business And as well, you can have like your life and your passions and your hobbies. You have the time. It's just like to be patient, but be prepared always.
Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. That's what we need. And I think who are listening, the new members, they follow your ideas first, then they will admire for your thing. So my final question is to you, what was your goal for the year?
I want to be card of the table again, obviously, because I was card of the table, then I returned to regular member, but I do know that I can do it. Obviously, I want to become top of the table later, but I'm like stepping up again, like from this difficult year that I told you about. I'm like renewing myself and transforming like in a personal way. So, and the MDR thing goal for me is a very good motivation. So I want to be card of the table.
All the best for you are top of the table. And before closing, this is what's long time we are waiting for it. Listen your voice. So can you sing some lines for our members to know? Anyway, I'm just going to put your ABEs and everything going to be there, but still the live voice of Fernanda.
Okay, but do you want me to sing in Spanish or English?
For me is everything. I work on heart, so all language come for me. If you are comfortable, you can talk about it. Sing about it. You can sing two songs also.
It's going to be in Spanish.
Yeah.
So you can learn from our songs, but well, you have my other like videos. I'm gonna send you some links and everything, or my Spotify, so you can share it with our friends, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so it's like I don't know. It's I get nervous. It's different, but okay. Are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay. Habíamos acordado que no ibas a regresar. Otra promesa más que no supiste respetar. Pero qué bueno que viniste. Ese día que te fuiste me quedé con ganas de expresar mis sentimientos, decirte lo que pienso, por ejemplo que te equivocaste, te reíste cuando hablamos de extrañarme. Quisiste ser como siempre el importante, tu estrategia infalible pisoteé, te equivocaste, pensaste que yo siempre iba a necesitarte, pues resulta que nadie es indispensable. Y planeabas regresar como si nada, con tu cara de perdón. Qué bueno que volviste, tenía muchas ganas de decirte que no. Thank you. It's not a love song. It's like I don't want you anymore song. It feels like I'm very like heartbroken. It's not. But it's like something that I like to sing.
Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. The energy level of the song is awesome. It's a God-gifted one. So God bless you.
Yeah, thank you. You can think it was like a good song, like a love song, and yeah, she's telling me good things.
it's a last I don't know, 1.5 hours I've been sharing with you, like you've been showing the real life what's happening right now. So we may be facing it, we may lose the members fast to be in a closed one, but still life must move on. we should be very strong. And that is what I'm doing this program, because people think that it is going to be end. I could not able to move forward. I have to give up. Never give up your dreams. Your passion is very, very important. And every day, every minute, you need to work on that. So the love, the way I started following you, or the way the passions you've taken up, whatever the profession you are, never give up your passion. That's what's been taking your next level. That you have come continually and comfortably transferring the business, as I'm wonderful for that. It is one of the ideas we can able to adapt for you. Thank you so much, Fernanda, all the way from Mexico. And there is no words to be explained about, I'm so energetic. I think whoever watching this video, they also are going to be energetic. And I'm just putting your links into the descriptions, and your email ID as well as my email ID will be there. If there are any more questions from Mexican members or other country members, definitely you'll get it. So we can able to connect back with you soon. Thank you, friends. It was a wonderful interview.
Thank you very much. I admire you a lot. Thank you very much.
So it was a wonderful program, and thank you, Fernanda, for connecting today. And it was amazing. And we are seeing one more hero. This is how the heroes have been created, and they are growing faster. And soon we will see you one more different ideas or different heroes will be into a program. Thank you so much. Wonderful day. And thank you, Fernanda, for joining today. Thank you.
Thank you, my friends.
So how you say in Spanish? It's like Grasta, right?
What? It's a Spanish song, and it's like
I'm saying that thank you, it isn't Grasta, right? Grasta.
Ah, gracias.
Gracias. Yeah, okay. Gracias.
Gracias. Okay. Gracias, amigos.
Amigos, yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Quiero estar bajo el embrujo.